Welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. In this session, we will discuss waveguide phase shifters. In waveguide phase shifters, rotary vane type phase shifter. This article comes in unit 5 of microwave engineering subject. So, rotary vane phase shifter. So, this is the arrangement of rotary vane phase shifter. So, this arrangement is very much similar to rotary vane attenuator. So, the difference is that in rotary vane attenuator, we use resistive cords, but in rotary vane phase shifter we use dielectric slabs. So this arrangement provides a phase shift to the wave when it travels through this section. See here the input wave with the phase of 0 degrees. So this is called as input transition. It consisting of three circular sections fixed in quarter wave plate, that means the plate, it is lambda by 4, rotatable half wave plate lambda by 2, where the dielectric slab can be rotated. So again the fixed quarter wave plate, so which is of length L. So this is the output transition. You can see that the first dielectric slab is fixed at an angle of 45 degrees with respect to perpendicular, where in the second one, in the second circular section, the dielectric slab can be rotated like that, which is shown as theta m, where theta m can be varied. In the third fixed section, this is the fixed section, second fixed section in fact, the dielectric slab is fixed at an angle of 45 degrees with respect to the perpendicular. So these are the, now see, let us see the operation of this rotary vane phase shifter. Number one, it consisting of three circular waveguide sections, two fixed and one rotatable. It consisting of three circular waveguide sections, two fixed and one rotatable. Two fixed sections are quarter wave plate, that is two fixed sections are quarter wave plate, whereas the rotatable plate is half wave plate. The rotatable plate is half wave plate, which we have discussed. So here the vector phasor is, the input is input, the phase of the input is 0, which represents the vertically polarized input wave. So that means the input wave is vertically polarized with phase of 0 initially. Now it may be decomposed into two components, parallel and perpendicular to the dielectric slab, so with amplitudes of E by root 2 into 0. So therefore we can see that this is vertically polarized input wave. So this vertically polarized input wave is resolved into two components. This component is parallel to the dielectric slab and this component is perpendicular to this dielectric slab with each of amplitude E by root 2 into 0, E by root 2 into 0. So that means this vertically polarized wave is resolved into two components, horizontal to this dielectric slab and vertical to this dielectric slab with the phase of 0. Now see, when a waveguide of length L, when the wave passes through this, how much phase delay it experiences? It experiences a phase delay of phase delay per unit length multiplied by length of the waveguide section. So therefore the total phase delay occurs when a wave passes to a waveguide of length L is beta L into L. How much phase delay experiences? It experiences a phase delay of beta into L. This concept we use in this rotary vane attenuator. Next, see the effect of input quarter wave plate is to delay perpendicular component by beta perpendicular into L and the parallel component by beta L plus pi by 2. See here, what is the electric field here? The perpendicular component is E by root 2 at an angle 0. The horizontal component at the input of fixed quarter plate wave is E by root 2 into 0. See, when this perpendicular component travels to this, it experiences a phase delay of, according to the formula, beta perpendicular into L. So the horizontal component, this horizontal component, when it passes at the output of the first quarter wave plate, it experiences a phase shift of beta perpendicular into L plus 2 pi by lambda into, because it is quarter wave plate, 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 4, it will get pi by 2. So therefore the horizontal component, parallel component experiences beta lambda into L plus pi by 2. So therefore at the output, you can see at the output of the first fixed section, the perpendicular component experiences how much phase shift? beta L. So this is beta L. The horizontal component or parallel component experiences a phase shift of beta L plus pi by 2. So beta L plus pi by 2. So this is at the output of the first quarter wave section. Now, because the second dielectric slab is at an angle of theta m, so therefore, first represent this diagram, same diagram with the dotted lines, in order to make the perpendicular component and parallel component to this dielectric slab, move these components by theta m in the clockwise direction. That is what we have seen. The perpendicular earlier component is moved by theta m, this component is moved by theta m. So this is the perpendicular component here at the input of this dielectric slab, and this is the parallel component to this dielectric slab at an angle of theta m. Now, so therefore what we are doing, we are adding theta m and we are adding theta m to this, because these are perpendicular and parallel components here. So therefore E by add theta m here and add theta m here, this is. So these two waves are at the output of first quarter wave section, are at the input of rotatable half plate. Now, coming here, what happens when the wave passes through this? Let us see what happens when the wave passes through this half wave plate. So what is that is discussed here, with the length of half plate is 2L. The perpendicular component, as for the formula what it experiences, the perpendicular component experiences a phase delay of 2 beta into L. The parallel component experiences a phase shift of 2 beta L plus, because it is half wave plate, lambda gets cancelled, so 2 beta L plus phi respectively. So therefore, when the wave passes from here to here, the perpendicular component experiences a phase delay of 2 beta L into L. The parallel component experiences a phase delay of 2 beta L plus phi. So that means, so to these input components, we have to add to the perpendicular component minus 2 beta L. So that and to this component minus 2 beta L minus pi. So therefore, so you get, by adding these two components, at this output, this perpendicular component faces this, and the parallel component faces this. Again, since because these components are not perpendicular to this dielectric slab, again rotate these phase components by theta m and theta m here. So that is what it is shown in this diagram. Now these components shows the components which are taken perpendicular to this dielectric slab. So again we are making this theta m, add theta m to this and theta m to this. This component will become minus 3 beta L minus 2 theta m. This component will become minus 3 beta L minus 3 pi by 2 minus 2 theta m. So this is, next let us see when this component, this is when this perpendicular and parallel component, when it passes through the last fixed section, let us see what happens. The output quarter wave plate delays these components by additional beta L and beta L plus pi by 2 respectively. As a result of this, the output components are E by root 2 minus 4 beta L minus 2 theta M, E by root 2 minus 4 beta perpendicular into L minus 2 pi minus 2 theta M. So what happens? So these are the two components, perpendicular component and a parallel component. When these two components passes through this, the perpendicular component suffers a phase delay of beta into L. So we have to add beta into L, it will become minus 4 beta perpendicular into L. So that is this component. And the horizontal component experiences how much phase delay expand? Beta L into L, beta perpendicular into L plus pi by 2. So add this things to this, it will become minus 4 beta perpendicular into L minus 2 pi minus pi by 2 minus 3 pi by 2 minus 4 pi. So these are the two components at the input of this output transition. Since you can see that these two components are phase, the vector addition of these two results a value of E at an angle of minus 4 beta perpendicular to L minus 2 theta. So this is the final phase shift achieved with this rotary vane attenuator. You can clearly see that what is the total sections 2L, 3L, 4L. So therefore according to the formula, how much phase shift it achieves? 4 beta perpendicular to L, 4 beta perpendicular, because it is theta m, again it is back theta m, so therefore we have to take minus 2 theta m. This is the phase shift that we can achieve with the help of this rotary vane attenuator. Lastly, because of accuracy, the rotary phase shifter is used as calibration standard in microwave laboratories. Because of this is so accurate, this rotary vane attenuators are used as calibrated phase shifters in microwave laboratories. So this is what we have to write in the examinations about this rotary vane phase shifter. Thank you.